Hey guys, welcome back or welcome to my channel. My name is Breanna and today I'm going to be taking you through my after school night routine. I'm going to be showing you some of my healthy habits, my new skincare routine, and a few other things. So without further ado, make sure to like and subscribe and let's get into the video. So I am at the library right now because usually I get more work done because everyone else is studying and I'm actually supposed to be in the quiet zone, but there's not a lot of people here right now. So I'm just gonna do some biochemistry and then I also have a little bit of editing to do, so I might get on that right now. I don't have any traditional college classes this semester and that requires a lot of self-studying, so I try to create and maintain routines every chance I can. This video is my ideal after school night routine. Once the traditional workday is over at like 5 p.m., I usually take an hour break before starting homework or revision of today's material. So here I'm revising biochemistry slides and also taking notes. I said in a previous video that one of my 2022 goals is to learn a new skill. So for the last month, I've been doing introductory lessons to Python on Data Camp. So huge shout out to Data Camp for making this possible. Data Camp is an online learning platform that makes acquiring data skills much easier and more convenient for beginners to pros. As a beginner, I can say my course has given me a solid foundation and a very smooth learning experience. The specific skill track that I have been doing is Python fundamentals. And as you guys know, I am a research assistant with my university. And so I wanted to learn the programming language R because it's heavily used in research for statistical analyses and data manipulation. And the reason I'm doing a Python skill track first is because it'll make learning R easier later on. So I highly recommend becoming data fluent because it'll help you stand out professionally, research positions, and other fields as well. So yeah, I highly recommend you invest in yourself and check out the link in my description box below and check out the first chapter of any course for free. So once I finished all of my studying for the evening, I usually take a shower to transition to a more relaxing evening. So here is my updated hair care routine. I wet my hair with lukewarm water to open up the pores of my scalp and hair fibers so my shampoo can thoroughly cleanse any oil or dirt away. I focus my shampoo on my roots because that is where the most oil is, and I have started to use a scalp exfoliator and massager. This one has very gentle and flexible teeth. It's from a Tangle Teaser and I think it's been pretty effective. I find that my hair gets less oily as fast and I have less buildup. Next, I'll rinse all the soap out and apply the Jisoo Honey Infused Hair Mask. I mainly apply this to the body of my hair, and guys, when I tell you this stuff is hydrating and makes my hair smell so good, I am not kidding. I never skip this step anymore and I always get compliments on my hair. After letting this sit for a few minutes while I do a body wash, I rinse it out and apply conditioner to the bottom half of my hair, focusing on the ends, which are the driest just because they're the farthest from your scalp. I'll also let this sit for a minute before rinsing it out with cooler water. I actually find that when I shower with hot water, my hair gets poofy and frizzy, but I know in theory cool water will help close your hair follicles and the hair fibers in general, so that's why it looks silkier, so maybe try that out next time. And if you try this out, let me know in the comments if this makes your hair less frizzy. You guys have seen my other hair care routines, and you know I usually bring my hair out with a cotton shirt just because it's less abrasive than a regular towel. And now we're gonna move on to my skincare routine. Okay, so I'm just gonna go quickly re-wet my face and I'll be right back. I'm gonna go in with the Ordinary's Hyaluronic Acid. I usually just do one full dropper of this, and you wanna apply this to already wet skin because it carries 1,000 times its weight in water, and you wanna be hydrating your skin, not drawing it out with this. Apply this all over and also down my neck. And I will be showing you guys how I do my gua sha later on. Also, your ring fingers are the most gentle, so use that around your eyes because you don't want to tug on the really thin and like sensitive skin here. And one of the most important things when it comes to laying your skincare is you want to focus on a penetration, so you go from thinnest to thickest formulas. So now I'm using Pharmacy Beauty Honeymoon Glow. This is a chemical exfoliant, too harsh to use on your skin every single day, so I only use this 2 or 3 times a week. This is really good for a cell turnover. I actually like to focus a lot of this on my forehead because it's the part of your face that hits the sun the most. Now I'm using the Body Shop's Aloe Soothing Night Cream. I would say that I have normal to oily skin and I still moisturize because one of the reasons why your skin is oily is actually because your skin is dehydrated and it's compensating for that with a greater oil production. So even if you have oily skin, don't skimp out on your oils and moisturizer. Now I'm going in with the Ordinary Salicylic Acid. They just reformulated this. I don't have many breakouts, just applying them problem areas. And you apply spot treatments after because you don't want to spread it all around with an overall product like moisturizer. And I recently got some acne scars over here and I've been fading them with Alpha Arbutin and I've actually seen a difference. Acne scars are really stubborn, so it really just takes a lot of time to fade these. And now this leads me to one of my favorite parts of my skincare routine, which is a gua sha massage. So I'm doing my facial massage with the Sachi Beauty Stainless Steel Gua Sha. In theory, this one works better than a traditional jade one because it's not porous and it's also naturally cooling. So I'm going to oil up my face and neck with the Ordinary's 100% Rosehip Seed Oil because you want to create a slick for your gua sha. You don't want to be tugging on the skin. That's just going to create wrinkles. I usually start in this kind of motion. So I'm going to start with my forehead and repeat each motion like 3 to 5 times. And you have like a pressure point right here. And now moving on to my under eyes, I'm going to use this part of the gua sha. I'm going to hold the skin here and be very gentle. Favorite part, I'm going to work on my jaw, and I really want to depuff my jawline, so I'm going to use the longer like prong on top. And you just want to drain the lymphatic fluid that you just took out of your face, and that's from the sides here. We depuffed the under eyes earlier, but you could also carve out cheekbones. Just be gentle around the eye. And then I usually just like pat in the oil on my face. It'll absorb eventually. Back to hair care. I'm using the Tangle Teaser finishing brush. I'm gonna go in with the Jisoo Honey Infused Hair Oil. I love this stuff. I usually use like 3 droppers and then I brush it through the bottom half of my hair. And usually I'll just let it air dry the rest of the way. But today I'm gonna blow dry my roots just to give myself more volume. So I'm gonna use the Jisoo Heat Protective Spray. I'm just gonna spray it on my roots and then blow dry it 60% of the way on low heat. Every Jisoo product smells so good. So I'm just gonna tousle my hair really quick. Another one of my New Year's resolutions was to find a more sustainable workflow or like video production pipeline. So I try to edit for 30 minutes to 1 hour every night. So I'm just gonna do that right now. This task makes me productive, but it's not necessarily stressful because it's usually just a rough cut and just eases the workflow later on in the week. I think I said this before in a Discord chatting session that I don't gravitate towards self-help books, but I got 101 essays that will change the way you think. And I basically just decided to like give it a try. I was surprised that they're not actually essays. They're kind of just like mini blurbs of stuff, but there's some interesting takes and some like reality checks. And then some things are kind of like self-explanatory, but overall not bad. I think it's a good introduction to self-help books. Nothing super spectacular or life-changing yet in the 100 pages I've read, but not terrible.